to make suffering endurable, to make evil intelligible, to make justice desirable and love possible. And so when he talks about what words can do to reality, I think there's no more important thing in the world.
Well, I certainly agree in general with both you and John and Updike. The way I put it in the book, as you know, is a sentence is an organization of items in the world. And that organization and the items you select and the way they are ordered will produce extraordinarily different worlds. But my view of what the writing is for is much less exalted than yours, or I suppose much more hermetic and aesthetic. I think that the point of writing is to produce great sentences that you can then look at as you look at a gem.
So for you, writing, it's the thing itself, not the power of the thing.
I think that, one can't deny, of course, that writing of all kinds has power, and there are many historical moments when great events have been traced, at least in part, to writing. But I'm not sure that writers themselves, even those who have what we might think of as a polemical or political purpose, have that in mind. I think what they want to do is craft.
But I don't. I agree in terms of a polemical purpose. But I do think craft almost automatically becomes something bigger than itself in the writers that the three of us would agree are the wonderful writers. I take this title of mine, Unless It Moves the Human Heart, from poet A.D. Hope, who said, I paraphrase it, but it's that your writing will not matter unless it moves the human heart, and the heart that you must move is corrupt, depraved, and desperately wicked. And I changed it a bit to say, and desperately in need of your love. But the sentence after sentence, word after word, the precision with which you look at the sentences in your book, then as they mount up, seem to me to create a whole new universe and a better one.
Join us online at charlierose.com.